we saw in the community picture, I didn't actually wear the thing costume. I wore something different, and I based it off of Palmer in the thing at one point. Which you'll see here. Yeah, right there, where the eyeballs popped, that's what I was looking at, and this is what I came up with. So I did want to be scary, a little gruesome, but not too scary, and not too gross, all at the same time. But I felt that this was a really good rendering of that scene, that part in the movie of Palmer in his transformation, to be scary enough for anyone who's coming up to my door. Now, this was supposed to be my last time in being dressed up for Halloween. I might do it one more time. Now, if I do dress up one more time, it will have to be Palmer with the new mask that I'll be making. And definitely a scene that's very, very scary. The scariest I've ever done before. To scare everyone. Now, I did base his hands off of a rendering model of Palmer, which they showed like he had some tentacles, and I saw these little ties, and this was actually perfect for what I was looking at accomplishing. I can move them, I can shape them, and they stay out of the way with the help of the fact of sewing them down and adding some hot glue along with the latex mixed with acrylic paint. Now, I am planning on making another mask of Palmer during his transformation, like what you see here, and then also a remake of what I have here, so that way it's not like a mirror image, and it'll be a little bit more slimmer mask that I'm looking at. But I do want to show the video of the kids. They were coming up, and there was a lot of brave ones who collected their candy. Now, bear with me, the audio will cut in and out, but that's only because of the service I have.
Oh, he doesn't need one. Thank you, though.
Now, and having some really cool neighbors and a great friendly community, it made handing out candy this year for Halloween really awesome for me and enjoyable. Bit too scary for this young trick-or-treater, and I felt bad, so I handed them an extra pack of candy because I did try to like scare them a little bit.
Thank you. Excuse me for my face.
Thank you.
You think if you put fake blood on you, it'll be more scarier? Mm-hmm. If you put fake blood on you?
Yeah, probably. I'll tell you more.
How does a pumpkin look?
That's the second.
What do you think?
Definitely, it was great and awesome to see my son and his girlfriend show up, and for her to see that, yes, you know, how I set up the scenes and how I do Halloween. And then, of course, they saw how busy I was, so they skipped out, which is fine. And one thing that was really cool was one of the kids out there, one lucky kid, if you're watching this video with your parents, hey, you're the one who got the knife from me. That was the extra prop. You were the lucky kid that was out there trick-or-treating who received a premium prop that I made out of foam board. So it was a big old Michael Myers knife. So congratulations to you. So I definitely like to hand out one free mask or free prop to one lucky trick-or-treater who shows up at my house to collect their candy. And it's a random pick. It's just, you know, hey, you know, not in greatest costume or whatever. It's just something that I see, and then I, you know, hey, I pick that person to receive that gift. So I look forward to next year, and, you know, hey, if you come by my house, you might be the lucky one to get that free mask or a free prop, something like that that I've made. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Trick or treat. Dude, you went all out, man. It looks dope.
Trick or treat.
You're the only one that I've seen with a line.
Yeah, it's a line like that.
I was down to my last four packs of candy. I handed those out and had to deliver the bad news that we were out of candy. But hey, that was 900 pieces spread out amongst 300 packs. So I had 300 kids show up and there were still more kids out there. They were coming in droves like I was saying there in the beginning. So hopefully next year I'll prepare again, maybe do to 1,200. But I'll spread it out to be like two candies per pack, which will be about 600 packs. So I look forward to next year. Hope you guys like this video. Like and subscribe. Thank you.
Like and subscribe.